Good afternoon. You've reached 999.
You're going to listen to exactly what I'm about to say. There are three bombs planted in some of the busiest areas in London. I'm going to call this exact phone back in 30 minutes. When I do, I want to speak to the Prime Minister. If I do not get my audience, bombs will go off.
You have reached 999.
Who am I speaking with?
You are speaking to the executive officer of this station.
I asked to talk with the Prime Minister.
The Prime Minister does not deal with terrorist threats. What can I call you?
Zed.
Okay, Zed. Are you aware that...
Listen. I am a mere button away from ending the lives of thousands of citizens.
Why? Why are you doing this? Zed, are you there? Zed, can you speak to me?
Charlotte. We were on the same course at uni. Pretty much fell in love straight away. We had so much in common. She was the only other person there that challenged me. She fell pregnant soon after we graduated, which left me to provide for the three of us. Straight out of uni. Although I graduated with some of the highest grades in my year, no one would hire me without any experience. How am I supposed to get experience if, in order to get some, I need experience? How do you expect me to feed my family, my daughter, for no pay? You sell a lie. Education means nothing. Unless you're rich, you can't just do what you want. I was forced to work in some shitty retail store. I fell into the routine of ceaseless bleeping. angry customers' screwed up faces that occasionally spat into mine. We were living on minimum wage. Charlotte was looking after our daughter. We had benefits. Not much. Enough to feed her and clothe her. The stress of trying to provide and being stuck in this mindless job became too much for me. I was diagnosed with depression. Soon I just stopped going to work altogether. All of my drive was just sucked out of me. I became a stay-at-home dad. Charlotte went back to work. We struggled, but for a while, we survived. One night, Charlotte came home late. She'd been working overtime. She was looking at me with a mixture of disgust and regret. I knew she'd hated me for what I'd become. We always had so much in common. Ironically, the pills that I'd been prescribed cushioned the blow when the knife went into my back when she mentioned the other man.
What do you expect to get out of this, Zed? This is nobody's fault. It's exactly the same for all of us.
You sold me a lie.
What do you hope to achieve, Zed?
Nothing. I just needed someone. Someone to listen.
I understand. Everybody understands. The way things are. You're being completely irrational.
Hello, Zero. This is Alpha 10. Wrong location. I repeat, wrong location, over.
I'm sorry, I don't think I got your name.
Me? Officer Forbes.
Thank you for listening, Officer Forbes.